Hello everyone, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 259. Indian Space Research Organization ISRO signs an MOU with the Chinese smartphone maker Oppo. Both the parties have joined hands to develop indigenous solutions based on NavIC, which is called as Navigation with the Indian Constellation, which is an autonomous regional satellite navigation system for India. According to the agreement, the ISRO and Oppo will develop the application for NavIC short messaging feature. The government's Department of Space and the Chinese tech company will exchange technical information of NavIC messaging service to build rapid, ready-to-use and end-to-end application-specific solutions. The personal Twitter handle of Prime Minister Narendra Modi was briefly hacked during the early hours of Sunday. While the account was restored shortly after a tweet promoting cryptocurrency had already been shared from the handle that was later deleted. Fraudsters are selling fake Fit2Fly certificates for 40 euros to passengers wanting to dodge COVID travel rules in a social media scam described by the government official as completely unacceptable. The Argus has found an online laboratory claiming to perform 36,000 tests per month. India will be coming out with the strong ecosystem of 5G smartphones before the official rollout of 5G. People are purchasing a new 5G smartphone in the country every day. The 5G spectrum auctions are expected to take place by the first half of 2022. And Jio also mentioned that India will be having around 100 to 150 million 5G smartphone users before the official launch of 5G. Asus has officially launched the Asus Chromebook CX1 in India today. The new offering by Asus featuring 11.6-inch anti-glare HD display, the Chromebook CX1 has a rugged build and it meets industry-leading MIL standard 810H US military test. The Asus Chromebook CX1 comes in a transparent silver color option. It will be available at a special launch price at ₹18,990 through Flipkart starting from December 15 to December 21st. After the other period, the laptop will be sold for ₹19,999. The Realme GT 2 Pro may come with a 1TB of storage capacity on the highest end model. The Realme GT 2 Pro will use a Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor. The Realme GT 2 Pro launch date may be on December 20th. Infinix Note 11 and Infinix Note 11S will go on sale through Flipkart. If we talk about the specifications of these two mobiles, Infinix Note 11 and Infinix Note 11S comes with a 6.7-inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display and 6.95-inch Full HD Plus 120Hz display. If we talk about the processor, Infinix Note 11 comes with a MediaTek Helio G88 processor, while Infinix Note 11S comes with a MediaTek Helio G96 processor. Both the smartphones will come with a 50MP triple rear camera, and both the smartphones will also come with a 5000mAh battery which supports for 33W fast charging. Huawei will be holding its latest 2021 product launch conference on December 23rd. Now a new report has revealed the list of the few of these new products that we can expect to be announced later this month. Huawei will be launching foldable phones, smartwatches, ink screens, PCs, speakers and more on December 23rd. Deezo Watch 2 Special Sport Edition and the Deezo Watch R will launch in India. These smartwatches will debut in the country by January end. The specifications of the smartwatches are under wrap at this moment. IQ9 to get a 4700mAh battery and a 120W fast charging support. IQ is likely to introduce the IQ9 model sometime in Feb in India. IQ9 will feature Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset, 120Hz AMOLED display, micro gimbal, PTZ camera and many other features. OnePlus C1 specification, price range and launch timeline revealed. This phone will feature a 90Hz AMOLED display, MediaTek Dimensity 900 processor and a 65W charging support. OnePlus C1 could arrive as a OnePlus Note 2 CE in India by mid-February. Previously, Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra has been spotted on the Geekbench benchmarking apps. This smartphone, alongside the Galaxy S22 and S22 Plus, is likely to launch in Feb at an Unpacked event. This smartphone has been spotted with the model number SMS908U on the company's official website in China. Looks like Samsung might also be interested in launching its electric vehicles in India. The trademark status has now been objected, but we might see some development in the coming months. Sony had indeed patent design for the PlayStation 5 console cover and now Sony has finally revealed the first collection in the series. The PS5 console cover Galaxy Collection is headed for release in January 2022 and will offer 5 distinct color variants. The collection includes the colors such as black, red, pink, blue and purple. Redmi K50 Gaming Pro has been approved according to the Digital Chat Station. There will be two gaming models, the Redmi K50 Pro Gaming and the K50 Standard Edition. Xiaomi is ready to launch the whole K50 universe. Redmi Note 11 4G is expected to launch globally in Quarter 1 of 2022. This handset will arrive globally with a Snapdragon 680 chipset instead of MediaTek Helio G88 processor. Redmi Note 11 4G price in India is said to be around $199, that is around ₹15,000 for the 4GB RAM and a 64GB variant. Realme secured the second spot this festive season with the market share of 18%. It shipped over 9.3 million units of smartphones, AIoT devices and tech life products in October 2021. Realme is within striking distance of Xiaomi, which had a 20% of market share. Xiaomi Watch S1 will be available in markets like Europe, Indonesia and Malaysia. The specifications have not been revealed at this moment and this smartwatch could launch in India as well. WhatsApp will make it hard for third-party stalking application to check your last seen. People or application that have not chatted with you cannot see your last seen details. Existing chats with family, friends and businesses will not be affected. Vivo V23 will be launching in India early next month, probably on January 4th. This handset is expected to arrive with a 64-megapixel primary camera on the back. The vanilla Vivo V23 will be launching after the Pro model. Broadband prices could see a minimum of 15% of price hike. This comes after telecom companies hiked tariffs on their prepaid plans. Jio and Airtel could soon announce a new broadband recharge plans in India. Popular content streaming service Netflix has announced a website called as Tudum. This is a dedicated website that brings news about renewals, release dates and extra content featuring its TV shows and movies. The website includes categories like Spotlight, News, Coming Soon, Trending, Popular Now, Trailers and News and so on. Amazon Prime membership is currently priced at ₹999. The annual plan will now cost 50% more starting from December 14th. The prices of monthly and quarterly Prime membership plans have now been hiked by 39%. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.